Governor Ralph Northam says those metrics are good enough for the Commonwealth to enter into phase three of its reopening on July 1st.
But tonight, a big announcement from Busch Gardens. The theme park is allowed to reopen, but tells us they won't be. 10 on Your Side's Brett Hall reports they are blaming the governor.
Starting July 1st, many of the places we can all go to have a good time, they'll be allowed to open for the first time in more than 3 months.
Places like Rosie's Gaming Emporium in Hampton, where gaming stations have been rearranged to keep gamers socially distant, and theaters like Regal and Cinemark, both plan to welcome movie fans back on July 10th. But when it comes to the world's most beautiful theme park,
Busch Gardens and Water Country USA will need to remain closed.
Park President Kevin Lemke says the governor's rules requiring the park have no more than 1,000 visitors at one time just does not make reopening worth it.
Our parks are largely outdoor facilities spread across hundreds of acres, but we continue to be lumped in with businesses with unrelated models like bowling alleys and skating rinks. This lack of nuance and detail to reopening guidance is unlike anything we've seen in all other states in which our company operates.
Lemke told the James City County Board of Supervisors that if the governor doesn't change course, the hit local governments are already seeing with the loss of tax revenue will just get worse. Not to mention the strain hotels and restaurants in the historic triangle are already under. He says the park is ready with a safety plan that's already working in parks in other states. It would require reservations for a day of fun on top of enhanced cleaning protocols. State Senators Monty Mason and Tommy Norman are pushing for the guest limit to at least be lifted to 5,000 at one time.
Five times what those numbnuts in Richmond were suggesting.
Lemke says that's still low, but gets them to a point where they could be back in business.
And we did reach out to the governor's office to see by chance if he is willing to change some of the regulations for phase three. We have not yet heard back. That's the latest. Brett Hall, 10 on Your Side.